133 tonight. Any actors at the moment?
Right now, I got somebody detained at the airport. I think he may have been an accomplice to either the stabbing or maybe a guy who stabbed some of these airport workers over here.
You need a 77, brother?
I got one already. I'm okay.
10-4. What the hell? Is it so smoky in here? Oh, yeah, chat. Last night, when I went off stream, I laid on my couch all fucking night. I just laying on my fucking side. Like, just like, the only thing I ate yesterday was some soup, and then I couldn't eat anything else all day. Are you streaming Siege? Not till next year because you asked. Oh, what the? I am. I got some Thai soup, which is from a different place that I. Oof, also, chat, hold on. Also, we've got that Riz thing today, and then Owen McNulty are going on the third date today. So I gotta figure out what the fuck we gotta do with this red dress, and I'm annoyed that I cracked jokes about that. I'm annoyed that I fucking agreed to that.
876,
bro, he cleans up so well,
guy
dude.
Guy dead in the middle of the road.
Why aren't you playing Rainbow? Because you asked. But like, you know what's worse, chat? If you don't commit to the bit. The hell is that? Oh, that's the judge's robe. I'm gonna have to get the ped. How the fuck do you do it again, though? I feel a bit better. My stomach isn't as bad. My energy is a little up. I'm trying to utilize it while I can. I don't think I can save my face ped. I'm gonna have to go to a barber.
Dispatch 103-10-8.
I'm Victor Jake.
10-2.
10-2.
McNulty, can you call me?
10-4.
Howdy.
Hey, what's up, brother?
Hi. So what happened? You need me to dress up as a woman?
Yeah. So they're hosting a Riz class at the Liquid Loyberry.
Till 8:24 tonight.
So right. I think you'd be a perfect companion up there on the stage. So you and I can have a good teach the world out there how to properly Riz and flirt.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, this is like under.
No. This is community outreach.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Community outreach. I like that.
Hold on. I can probably tell you when it's starting. Give me a sec. In an hour or in 20 minutes? You want to do it in an hour?
Oh, shit. That damn Ramaswamy trial's happening in a little bit.
That's today.
I think so. Am I wrong? Ain't that what Slack said?
Well, I don't know. Is he around? Why don't you ask him?
Yeah, I was gonna go to that Ramaswamy trial.
You can go to that. I can roll solo. No worries.
Damn. Shit. Well, I mean, they're doing this in an hour as well?
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Like they can say, we can do 20 minutes or an hour.
Well, shit, I might, Let me find out when...
Yeah, get back to
me. You can do it in 20 minutes?
Yeah, I'm double checking. Because if they think they can do it in an hour when at the same time the Ramaswamy thing's going on, they might be having their their viewers, Let me see if they know that that's going on and get back to you. Find out if the trial's in an hour, will you?
All right, let me know. Yeah, I'm code corn MRPD.
All right. What did the play? Does that mean he needs to shit? Is the Ramaswamy poor case today?
Yes, hopefully. In about 45 minutes, if I can run fast enough.
Want a lift? Do you need a lift?
That would be amazing.
What's your 20?
I'm on Portola by the clothing store.
In real.
I had a wee headache and then my car disappeared.
Hello, Mr. McNulty.
How are you, Sue? How are you doing?
Yeah, not too shabby. Not too shabby at all, except for all the headaches.
Yeah.
Five headaches.
Yeah. So, 20 minutes, yes. But obviously, if you can do a bit of advertising, that'd be lovely. However, if you want to do an hour, you can obviously get more advertising out. But the problem with that is the Ramaswamy core case, big political thing, is on in an hour.
Ooh, good call.
Yeah. So... Personally, I can do it in 20 minutes, but I think you'd rather want to turn out, right?
Probably. I mean, I have a twat ready to go.
My advice would say maybe push it or we can do it tomorrow. One of the two.
Yeah, do you want to show me say tomorrow?
That's good for me. Either way.
Hell yeah. All right. Do you want to say like this time tomorrow?
Yep. Spot on.
Perfect.
Also,
right, we'll
I'm gonna have Cornwood come up dressed as a woman. Me and him are gonna get up there and teach people how to chat.
Oh, that is so perfect.
Yeah,
I'll
don't worry,
drink Cornwood.
Don't you worry, Sudi. I know how to entertain.
You are brilliant.
Okay, no worries.
Thank you so much. We'll make sure that there's plenty of tips for y'all.
All right, appreciate you. We'll catch you tomorrow, all right?
Catch you tomorrow, McNulty.
Yeah. Bye bye.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Happy to save the damsel in distress.
I was up in the hills. There's the same grey sentinel seems to be doing lots of 37 and trespassing. Then I had a little headache and I don't know where my car went and I don't know where Duncan went, but he's gone.
Oh, that's not good.
And then
you lost a whole ass CVPI.
Well, I did, yes. Don't worry, it was stuck in first gear, so I think we're okay.
That's cancellation. We'll see you later, innovator.
Thank you.
My pleasure, York.
What are you up to?
It's going to go after patrol.
Good stuff. Yeah, mm-hmm. Grey Seminole up in the hills. Guy in a black suit, red tie.
Gotcha.
Same over and over. Thank you.
Forward, what's our 20?
I'm at the room getting changed.
Okay, pause.
Oh,
Jesus. Okay, so it's not happening in 20 minutes, but we're going to do it tomorrow this time. How's that sound?
McNulty, you made me get... You know how long it took me to get dressed?
I'm sorry, you look beautiful. You look like a true American beauty. I'm so sorry.
You know how hard it is to get this thing on and off?
I imagine it's very easy. Look like you're sliding to it, no problem.
Damn it, McNulty.
Well, look, now you're prepped for tomorrow.
Hey, what time tomorrow?
This time, tomorrow.
This time tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
Because I basically was like, look, you can start in an hour, or and you'll be competing with the Ramaswamy trial, which I'm pretty sure is going to steal a lot of people. Or we can do it in 20 minutes, and you won't have any time to advertise and get people down there, so.
Okay. Yeah, it makes sense.
How's the day been?
It's been a dadgum shit show, McNulty.
How so?
Hell, you know, people going in court and, you know, he said, she said, she said, he said, and, you know, this guy did that. You know, this guy's obviously a criminal. This guy's doing this shit. And, you know, people getting shot in the morning before I got on duty. And
Jesus. Who got shot? Just,
I don't even know, actually. Apparently, apparently four people got shot.
Jesus. No report at all.
Oh, I'm sure it's on there.
Oh, there it is, Mayor Park shooting. What the fuck? Who's reporting officer? The Rolo. Okay, I'll catch you out there, Cornwood, okay?
All right, McNulty. Sounds good. We'll be seeing.
Okay, now we can go work on that outfit. So tomorrow, Cornwood and McNulty are hosting a Riz class at the Liquid Library.
Radio check.
And two.
Can I get a PD unit to... the hospital? We got a woman here who was brought in with a bullet to the head with no memory.
Jesus Christ. 133, I'm in route. Where'd you pick her up from?
Is her name Dan Fan?
Entry 323, Crusade. What's our 20?
Tanner?
With the 47.
Hey. We're at the hospital. I apologize. We're in the emergency room. I'll meet you out in the lobby.
Hum, McNulty, 123.
Difficult. Ugh. For introverts, but you know.
Sorry about that, sir. There were a lot. All good. Don't worry about it. What's up? Where is she?
Right back here.
Was she brought in by someone?
I don't know. I think it was local EMS or something. I'm not sure.
Bollocks.
Yeah. So right in this room. Hey guys.
How are you, lads?
Hey there, McNulty.
How are you, Graves? Friend of yours?
Yeah, a friend of mine, yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Ours.
Okay. Is she conscious at all?
She is, a little bit.
She's a bit weak right now.
That's fine. Okay, my name's Officer McNulty of the LSPD Badge 133. Whenever you're comfortable and you feel like you have the energy to do so, I'm going to have to just give you a few questions, okay?
Excuse me.
You just,
I'd be happy to give you a statement of what I know, though.
That's perfect. You have one?
As much as I can.
That's perfect. Yep. All right, I'm just going to give her a moment to rest. Can I chat with you in the other room there?
Sure, yeah.
Dispatch, show 133, I'm going to be 10-7 Crusade investigating the shooting. Okay, 1 second, just throw a report up. What's the name of the lady out there?
Clementine.
See,
I could tell you her surname, but I can't.
That's okay. I just need something short for the start of the report. What's your name, brother?
Kieran Bell.
Kieran Bell. Already flashed me your ID. Oh, that license is expired, brother.
Yeah, I was trying to go down today and get it sorted, and then all this shit went down, you know.
Okay. Talk me through on transport today, please.
Right, so to the best of my knowledge, right, a friend of mine, his name is Arthur McGuire. There's already an open investigation.
Dispatch 38, eastbound Center Street with the green colored
Arthur
glove.
Arthur McGuire was shot in relation to, he's starting up a sanitation union, because there's so fucking many of them these days. He was shot, and it's believed to be something to do with LSSU, which is the Los Santos Sanitation Union, a competitive union. From then, we were trying to figure out what's going on, what the details are, you know, why has a simple fucking union resulted in a fucking shooting? But he got the number of the person who it was, and I've got the number here. So I saved the number in my phone.
Did you already report that number?
I don't know if he did or not at the time. Arthur did or not at the time.
Read it out to me real quick.
420. 947.
Yeah.
6745.
Okay.
So that's the number of the person who phoned him to quote unquote sell materials and then ended up shooting him. Clem later gets a strange call. Clementine, girl over there, gets a strange call about someone wanting to meet up for a date and possibly going down into the sewers. Clem is a homeless lady. She likes to kind of explore places. Right?
Okay, and this is what happened just now.
Yeah, so she got a call from the strange person, didn't know who it was, apparently spoke to them, wanted to meet up at a clothing store, arrange a date, go down into the sewers. So I'm like, okay, well, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. She read me out the number, and I looked it up my phone because I'd saved this other one, and it was the same number. And I was very much against it at the time, but I figured, you know what? She wasn't involved in any of this material stuff, so let's figure out what's going on.
And then she got shot.
She went into the clothing store. We waited outside around the corner a little bit, drove back around again to see a fella standing outside in a blue jacket. Clem wasn't standing outside. Came back around the other corner, and this was the clothing store. I did put in a 911 about this. This is the clothing store. Let me pull up my GPS and check again. Lost the Boulevard. This was happening up there, that clothing store. I put in a 911 saying that there was an issue because he was standing outside and she wasn't. And I know that's not Clem. Clem would have moved with him so that we could see her. We lost eyes on her. They got into a car and drove off. We went in and checked the closed door. It was empty. We looked around, couldn't find anything. Looked around everywhere we fucking could, couldn't find anything. The big headache happened with everyone. We woke up, we tried phoning her, nothing. We figured, fuck it, we just gotta check the hospital. Came down here to check the hospital, and she's here. Now she's here, and I get a phone call. And I have this guy saved in my...
Same number
phoning me, and I'm a part of the union now, not LSSU's union. I'm a part of the other union, the one that Arthur was in and is getting set up, and he phones me trying to buy materials. Now I'm not going to lie to you, officer, I mouthed off at him. I called him out for being exactly what he is, a sniveling piece of shit. a dog.
Any kind of accent?
I couldn't quote it. It's, I want to say American, maybe Canadian. I don't know.
Okay.
High pitched voice, definitely not as deep as you or I or even Tex over there, but not like squeaky high pitched, just like fast paced, high pitched kind of thing, you know. The only description of the fellow we have is that he's got blonde hair. He was wearing a blue coat. I think he had a backpack on. And a mask.
You said a blue jacket, mask, blonde hair.
Yeah, a blue jacket, like a big, big blue long sleeve jacket, like a coat, like my coat almost, but slightly thicker.
Okay. All right, perfect.
I don't know if there was a hood on it. But that's unfortunately, that's all.
That's okay. That's more than enough to work with.
Yeah, and I always tell the officer he's got a gun, so.
Yeah. She okay? She responsive?
Yeah. I mean, she's weakly responding.
You feel like you're strong enough to answer a few questions?
Yeah, let's
don't remember anything.
It's up to you, sweetheart. You can answer what
you do not have to answer me if you do not want to. Simple as. I'm not going to force you to answer anything.
I don't know anything.
You don't know anything?
I don't remember what happened.
Do you remember any kind of description of this individual? What the kind of weapon he had?
Nothing.
Okay.
I don't even remember today.
Okay, I'm going to write down my number, pop it in your hand there. You remember anything? Or, you know, you see this person again, you call me immediately, okay?
Okay.
Okay. All right, Mr. Graves, I assume you two have seen the exact same thing.
Yep.
Okay.
Same exact right. thing, yeah.
Okay. Unfortunately, that's all I can do, but I do have enough to work with, okay? Appreciate your time, and I appreciate you calling in. Thank you. Is there an officer on Freak that's investigating the sanitation shootings?
Triple one to EMS. We might need Senior Buns also.
I'll tell A24 10-8 if another medic could grab the Senior Buns call.
Wow, good job. Yeah, good job, huh?
Shmarty?
Hey, I've been very good. Don't turn this around.
I'm starting to think you want to run into me.
Honest mistake.
Fuck. Honest, you were going 68 miles per hour.
68? Where are you getting these fucking numbers from?
My radar, Shmarty. Have you been good?
Radar. I have been good.
What have you been up to? What have you been doing to keep busy?
Group 6.
Plenty of group sex. Is that all?
Yeah.
Nothing else.
Dispatch 107.
I've been pulled over. Nothing too silly. Nothing too goofy.
I mean, I've been pulled over, but during group 6.
Okay, let's try to keep it slow. I know you're trying to make your ends meet.
Yeah. So we're good?
Yeah, you're fine. Slow the fuck down.
All right. Thank you. December 18th.
Okay, buddy. I gotta write this report.
Make sure we have EMS coming to Senior Buns, correct?
I gotta write this report while it's fresh in my mind.
Will you?
If I start waffling the fucking goddamn Schmarty, I'll. Hey, you're holding up traffic there, Sor.
Doing paperwork, just got done with a traffic stop.
Then why are your lights still on? You're just taking up traffic. Boom. Big traffic holder upper over here. Huge.
How about you get some tickets on?
Uh. Shit. What was that guy's name? Kieran Bell. Oh, fuck. Whoops. Number 18th is when I pulled him over, and he vows that I'm the reason he's gonna start doing crime.
Dispatch 103, clear traffic 10-8. Citation given. You copy that, McNulty?
Hey, sorry, just to confirm, do we have EMS coming to Senior Buns?
If hey, not, we can transfer. On the way.
10-4. No rush. I was just asking, making sure y'all heard us.
He said the clothing star off of Patola.
103 to Big Air direct.
Big Air extended.
1-25 at Mission Room.
Copy, 76.
133-76 Portola Drive clothing star. Looking at the scene of a shooting. Not be going this fast, especially in these conditions. Hey, Kira, what's up?
Hotel 876 Central Hospital with Osvaldo. Echo 1023.
Oh, and our fucking flashlights don't work. Fucking son of a bitch. Get in your night dress. Back again. Time to out cringe O tonight. Paying for phone numbers. Can I even swap my ped? How the fuck did I do it last time?
And I'm 23. Excuse me, I'm 76 at the courthouse.
I can't remember how I did it last time, chat. And I don't want to fuck up the... I don't remember how to do it. I would have to remake McNulty. And that just... Oh... Save your face first. Bro, I don't even know how. Wasn't there a way to save this shit? Well, I need the female. Well, I'll discard that. But the thing is, I don't think I can put, if I choose a female ped, I can't choose male hair, can I? Oh, fuck. 100% I'm getting robbed. No, I can't. Shit. Oh, fuck. Okay, we're gonna have to, we need to cook. We're gonna have to cook.
Dispatch 107, traffic westbound Lindsay Circus outside LSBN. Black Glendale, Ikebud 1.
Which way you turn around, Liz 48? Yeah, but I can't give him his look. I can't give him a beard and everything. Like, I can't make him look like McNulty is the problem. Oh, they're riding with someone.
Get a license on you, Otis. Oh, it's not Tyrone.
Otis. Echo 1024, the 911 at Senior Buns, 10-8.
Yeah, well, he did just say his name, that's true.
So when I just put myself in, he bones over. Not quite Tyrone. No, that's not. That's what you wanted to do.
I mean, route latest 911.
10 is also 76 to the latest 911.
Dickhead. Oh god, I thought that just blew up. Carlo is a little fuckboy. Find another way.
One 87, 197 direct.
How do we get to the damn first report, the phone directory report?
You mean like the PD contacts?
Yeah.
It's in the, just search up the word contact. Come on, Cornwood. I think you're speeding. Wow, look at that. Thanks for that update, bud. I'm telling you, man. The CVPIs are not that bad.
Bubba.
Oh, wow. That is a... My eyes! Oh, wow.
Person who's not speaking loudly enough for me to hear them.
Oh, I didn't say anything.
Oh, hey.
Hey, someone who's not looking at my lips.
I was looking at your lips.
And I wasn't saying anything. Why, poor word? Sora, are you okay?
He asked me if his arm was still attached, but I can't tell when it's in its sleeve.
It hurts.
Wait, well, I'm not medically trained to really deal with that. EMS is on the way.
All right. You got a handle on this. I'm gonna chop a tree.
Have fun, don't talk to strangers.
I talked to that guy. If I didn't, he might be dead.
Well, that's the cat's fault, really, though, not yours. EMS is literally right here. You're gonna be okay, okay? Mortar Kitty's dealt with, gonna stay in the area in case it's got any friends.
Get it, we're almost there.
Your legs are definitely not going to need to be cut off, okay? I don't know who even brought that up. Whoever they are, that's not a funny practical joke. Okay? They're going to be fine. They're fine. They're not mangled in any way. I'm sure those teeth marks are, you know, a tetanus shot or something.
Do we just have the one?
Yeah.
All right. Can you hear me, dear?
I'm going to remain standing on top of my police car with a gun out. No problem.
I'm going to take the lead on this one.
Bobbler, thanks to your two for 22 months.
Did you pass out before we got here?
Have you been awake the whole time?
No, I keep going unconscious.
How bad are the lacerations? Do you have yourself hungry?
The lacerations are pretty.
Oh, okay. Just bust out.
It's mostly concentrated on the leg. Let me take a look. No, never mind. It is everywhere.
Oh, okay. Oh, hello again. All right, I'm going to go ahead. Let me know when she's got the bleeding under control, and I'll get my
beast. 876 to the clothing store, 911.
Okay, get this unraveled.
Yeah, no, the murder kitty got mm-hmm. all his.
I'm gonna
put a compression bandage up here on the head.
But
get that bleeding stopped and cleaned away.
I'm gonna get a tourniquet on his leg.
Nah. Well, that's a really tall cat.
Radio check.
And two. Am I still waiting? What the hell? Well, while I'm up north, Chad, I might as well look for some weed. And two.
And two.
Dispatch 197, 1041, 1080.
Till 8:24.
It's a Trojan deer.
Echo 101, 1041. Hola, people.
What the fuck was that? Been looking for some time now. Keep doing what you're doing. Appreciate that, Vetsko. Hope you're enjoying the content.
Thank you again, McNulty.
Hey, it's no bother at all.
Appreciate you, McNulty.
You're the best.
I know. Dispatch 133, 1080, mortar candy, you know, disposed of.
It's a 1076, Central Medical, 147.
Dispatch 107, traffic eastbound Vespucci. Here's Cross Prosperity. Very 7 o'clock, bad one.
Last mix, last cat. Line them up like ass cats. Well, I gotta call Owen to tell her the bad news.
Sweetheart.
Oh, you have bad news.
Oh, no. What?
Yeah, the barber doesn't exactly want to work with me. I feel like I got to, you know, make sure I look right to slip into a dress. So I'm going to have to cook a little bit.
Okay.
I'm going to try my best.
I mean, worst case scenario, just formally. But wear red.
That was my backup. You know, that's plan C.
Okay. I mean, either way, I know I'm going to look drop dead gorgeous. So, you know.
Well, I'll be the judge of that, really.
Buckle up.
Buckle up, she says. Why, are we starting in the car?
Maybe.
Oh.
You're lucky enough.
I'm lucky. Okay. I am Irish, so. Mm-hmm. Luckiest people out there.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm going to get back to work. Someone got shot in the face, so bye-bye. Okay.
All right.
Buckle up, buckaroo. Nobody looks better than Cornwood. That's your true ERP goal. Daddy Cornwood. A flatbed.
631 Bravo.
Hotel 8. That's
23 in your buns.
What?
Hmm.
He's gonna go fight one of the mods. Hell yeah. No, 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 no. Back when you get bent over. My money's also on Tay.
Bill 876 Central Hospital 147.
197 UTL 31 Bravo tonight.
All right, chat. Let's see what we can cook up in
Echo 101-76 Central Medical 147.
Not if he's 5'4". Oh, I forgot that he's short. That it's even older. And I've met him in person, like, oh.
Hotel 820. 5'4
is being generous.
10-7 to write a report.
Echo 101, 23, Central Medical.
Million of the people. When there's people like you. This song bugs me sometimes, so we're gonna skip this. Okay, chat, how the fuck are we gonna do this? I thought there was like a big, like, over the top dress that men could wear. I remember popping it on being like, what is that? Maybe it's an undershirt.
Never.
Yeah, the drag dress.
Go 1023 Central Medical.
No, they melt inside.
One 41. Do you have any 277s available? 197. 25 with me and Mr. Up 80. I need one more too, if possible.
76. Where at? Mission Row?
Yeah, confirm.
Right, I'm at the courthouse right now. Yeah, do you know what? Do you know this Ramaswamy trial's happening in 20 minutes, ain't it?
Yeah, I need one or two 77 to help me arrest him, MRPD, and bring him to the city hall.
10-4, I'll be there.
I think we're going to have to go formal, chat.
Shit, actually, technically, could I do that?
I mean, you should probably be at the city hall. I want to get involved in an arrest.
All right, 10-4, I'll just wait here.
155, I'll take his place.
133, I'm already at MRPD.
Yeah, I'll take 377. That should be good. Come 25 with me on in front of Mission Row PD.
Trust me, I'll enjoy arresting Ramaswamy. Dude's irritating as shit. Obviously, I don't let my my personal political opinion get in the way of my policing, but I find this guy an irritating prick.
Oh, you don't like day one? It's R A.
Oh, yeah, Arthur.
S Q A R M Y.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you over Duncan. What's up?
Can you get on duty? All
right,
hurry up. Get a cop car. Everybody get a cop car right now. I need every single person with a
day
cop car.
Day one.
I'm going to punch you in the...
Dispatch 103.
I will catch an assault charge.
Glendale, southbound on Morningwood.
We'll do four
cops. Made a right on Dreadock Street. 22 on Perth Street. Left southbound North Rockford. 1050, we're BCB.
Okay, I'm going to go on duty.
All right, I'll be outside in my car, okay?
22 that, we got eyes again on the vehicle. It's going northbound Morningwood onto West Eclipse. This thing is taking off from us. We got to activate. Do we have any additionals for this? Right, eastbound Dorset.
103, you're not have additionals for at least 5-10 mics. We're making an arrest at Mission PD and following a mayor candidate, so.
Okay, no worries. Me and Big Eric are, we're doubled up anyway. There's only one person in this car. We can handle it for now.
Hey, some of the locals in here are starting to cry and bitch and moan. You know, I might have to... I'm gonna have to take care of them. You're gonna be annoying as shit during the court case.
No, I haven't, Doc.
Officer, so I keep calling the officer. Goddamn, Prosecutor Hall, you want to explain to him the procedure?
Yeah, to represent as a prosecutor.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying what.
Say that again, Cap. You're very quiet.
Oh, can you hear me right now?
Yep. You're good.
Can you put the cop car mirroring the other cop car? So let's have,
like a line.
Like the hoods are facing each other. We're gonna make them walk through all this and then go through the side exit.
Ooh, the vehicle had a hard 50 right over by the courthouse. It's now taking off westbound on Carcer Way. Did a U-turn, now they're going eastbound on Dorset. Headed straight towards Los Segundos. I can hold comms since we're gonna be the only people on this.
Oh, I gotcha. Unprivileged swine.
Nave, there's a pursuit going on that had a crash over there.
Am I the only one who heard multiple shots at City Hall?
Hey, from you have Officer York with you right now. We're at Mission PD.
I hear someone go, day one. Are you gorgeous?
What's going
on? Arresting Ramaswamy. Because he's a loudmouth prick. Or, you know, because he witnessed, you know, took part in a...
Yes.
A killing.
Oh.
The loudmouth prick part is just my personal opinion.
Okay.
One, if not both of those. Facts.
Well, one's just a personal opinion. You can't be arrested.
Yeah.
He is very loud.
Yeah.
And would you No, Duncan. No.
Duncan, please.
That's RamaSqrmy.
Is it bad that I call him a strong sound?
I don't want to be around him. He gives me a headache.
Look at that car livery.
A little cheetah print.
Huh.
Well, you like cheetah print.
Think
it can look nice in like certain like clothing. You know, I think it has to be done right.
I think it's a look that you have to be very proud to wear, and that's the only way you can pull it off.
That's true. You have to
own it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Something you gotta kind of strut in.
So, I just realized something. We're putting on a bit of a show arresting him. Isn't that what he's gonna want?
Gam's orders.
Yeah.
He's gonna want that. He's gonna be like, look what the woke mob is doing to us right here.
Oh,
folks.
Stop.
God to the damn it.
The worst part is that Duncan's right. He's gonna say that. He's gonna say exactly that.
Let's keep your leaf out. I'm coming around.
I think I'm too sleepy for this.
I got visual of him. He's running in a bush.
Well. No one can force you to stay on duty.
Melatonin Max is paying Boyger? The police to arrest me.
That is, you actually do a pretty good.
What is that?
What is that?
He's taking off back towards the street.
The firearm call in Labor Place.
Oh, that's officers. There's officers there. That's us.
Dispatch, just for an update, we're in a foot bail on Pudge Lane.
One of them's holding lethal, so.
What's up with these locals calling in police with guns?
I'm gonna go quickly before. Back up that foot pursuit cap.
Sounds good. Archer, go get a cop car. Oh, so you're going with him.
No.
Let's see here.
Nope.
That was the most timid but firm no I've ever heard. Nope. The boys now full pursuit.
Yeah, we got 195.
All right, I came to back up the foot pursuit, but never mind. Run out back to PD.
Yeah, big bear, getting big bones. You know, you got it handled.
You're boning Barrick. 10-4.
Oh yeah, we're boning.
How are you doing, darling?
Good. Like I said, sleepy. Trying to wake up.
Your widow EP?
Mm-hmm. How are you doing?
Honestly, not great. Something's up with my stomach at the moment. I'm not very happy. I'm not very comfortable at the moment.
Well, I hope that gets better.
Me too. You should put your vest on.
Yeah, I will.
Eric, I put a report up. Just title is Pursuit. President.
Lights. Anyone say anything? Is anyone saying anything? Oh, God.
Hello, Captain!
Mr. Ramaswamy, Ms. Volker. We are the Los Santos Police Department. We're asking the both of you to turn yourself in for one charge of attempted murder and one charge of accessory to attempted murder.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I love to hear about my rights.
If you can come closer. Officers to my right, officers to my left, we'll proceed forward, we'll place you in cuffs, we'll take you inside.
Yes, sir.
Oh yeah, face away from me there, please.
You have the right to remain silent.
We place you in cuffs, okay?
Any will be against you in the court of law, you have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one will be appointed to you by a state.
Make sure
available.
You self-cuff him afterwards.
Yep.
Morning, right, Mr. Ramaswamy. You have the right to remain silent. You say Canada is against you in a court of law. You have the right to attorney present if available. If you cannot afford one, we'll be appointing you free of charge by the state. Do you understand these rights as I read them to you, sir, ma'am, and or them, and or they?
Oh, yeah.
You do?
Oh, I do.
You should be able to move a little bit.
Absolutely.
There we go.
You mess from PD.
I love complying with the boys in blue, let me tell you. I support you all the way.
We have a 52 request on Amarillo Vista.
Call the captain.
Amarillo
Vista, you said?
Amarillo Vista, yeah, I'm coming. Off of El Rancho. And a gentleman here ejected from his car.
All right, Echo 10 is 76.
They might. Maybe just so you don't understand them, so I can say it again.
Yeah, I can read them for you again if you like.
I'd love that.
Mr. Ramasquam, at this time you have the right to remain silent. I mean, sir, do can and will.
Oh, was it my accent? Of law, you have the right to That's becoming a real problem. One will be provided to you free of charge by state if available. Do you understand the rights? Oh, I do. Is my accent that thick?
Sometimes.
Is it just when I read the rights? Because that's a problem. Should I, like, try Americanize myself a bit?
Maybe you just need to, like, say them a little slower.
Slower?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right. You have the right to remain... Now, but that makes me sound illiterate.
Makes it sound like you're reading.
You, you have the right... looks at hand. They need to be sourced and documented.
What's even going on?
10, 7,
there's a video out there basically of
request.
Little fucker stabbing someone.
I thought Ruby said that this was all going to go to trial or
it
something.
It is, right now.
Oh, okay.
I assume they've gone this way.
It's the coolest state of America, sorry. Yeah, go ahead and uncuff him as well, please.
Do you want us to search Make sure you search him.
Seize their positions.
Yeah. Pat him down, search him.
Oh. Vivek, I'm going to be patting you down, all right?
Okay. If you have enough here, sir, Archer and I get out there, okay?
Just help Vivek, us to the city hall and break
okay?
off afterwards.
No worries. We'll wait outside of them by the cars, okay? Mm-hmm. Unless you want to sit around in there and wait, you just gotta wait by the car and escort him to the city hall.
That's fine.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything and... it's harder to actually think about saying I'm slower. I don't know why to horse my brain a little bit.
I always try to say it without taking a breath.
No, that just makes you want to say it quicker. You have the right to remain silent. Will be... I'm okay. I think the Irish are just, you know, we're just, you know, we have a lot to say, so we feel like, I feel the need to say it quickly. Mm-hmm. I need to have a smoke. Is Turner on duty?
Think so.
You think so?
I don't think so.
You won't tell him if I have a smoke here, will you?
If he asks, I'll snitch.
What? What? Archer!
What? I'm not gonna lie to a captain.
That's a white lie, though.
If he doesn't ask, I'm not going to say anything.
If he's like, have you seen anybody smoking? You're like, oh, I saw McNulty smoke there yesterday.
Excuse me. So I don't mean to interrupt. Would one of you perhaps be able to pick up Officer York at the courthouse?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Do you want to stay there? All right. Never mind. You're okay. You're okay.
Oh, that was my last cigarette. Oh,
no.
I didn't even get to smoke it.
Well,
Not supposed to smoke here anyways.
Man, it's strange. I hear some kind of bird squawking that really has no say in anything. Well, no, no cigarette.
Hey,
my hands are shaking.
Are we going to be in the big courtroom with this?
ASAP.
Yeah, you look good on the dance floor.
I'm in a picture on Twitter.
Oh?
So are you.
Where? Woke mob weaponizing the police. Hey, look, we're famous!
Yeah.
And they got your good side.
Should I retweet this and say, that's me?
Yeah, you can. Why not?
No, Sox might get mad at me about it.
Live a little. Go on.
No. I already told him no.
You already went, nope.
No.
Did you oversleep or did you take a nap if you only just woke up?
No, I mean I've been, you know, in my apartment. Just sleepy.
You're always sleepy. You wear socks in bed.
Do I?
Yeah.
No. Why?
Okay. Just curious.
Why?
2452 request.
So I wanted to find out if you're a crazy person or not.
Oh.
It's a big red flag.
I think you get overheated.
Exactly. And it's a joint red flag because it's weird. I don't trust it.
Hmm.
I mean, I sleep in boxers year round. And no, obviously no socks. Although there's nothing fucking worse than when you're in bed with someone and they put their cold feet on you.
Dispatch 107 around Mission Row 195.
That's how you catch hands. Also, are you the kind of person where I feel like the world is split into two people. People that, oh no, sorry, three people, sorry. One, people who aren't ticklish. Two, people who aren't ticklish. And three, people that if you try to tickle them, will full on assault you.
Smash 107 arrival.
No, I'm not really ticklish.
People say that, and then you try to tickle them, and then they will pull out a knife and be like, don't fucking tickle me.
That's funny.
What's the god? It's the truth,
true.
Though. It's the truth,
it's true.
Though.
Yeah, some people freak out.
No, all mine are gone. It doesn't work on me anymore.
God, he's so annoying.
Yo, wait.
You should ask Duncan that question.
Duncan?
I gotta go pick up their lawyer. What's up?
Oh, okay, go ahead.
Here, give me a call.
Wait till he gets back. I want to hear
his. It's one of his numbers, so.
What is big titty?
I feel like. his reaction to that question will be funny, like, whatever the answer is.
I feel like Duncan will be, I'm not ticklish. I was never tickled. I actually don't know. Just gonna think about something. The fuck's my phone, chat? I put my phone, bro. Pat, what did you do with it? Where were you, Nyanyi? Okay, chat, I found it. I don't want to jinx it, chat. But I think my stomach is settled. I don't want to jinx it, but... Okay. Mentally prepared.
Okay.
What's the worst Christmas you've ever had?
What's the worst Christmas?
Yeah.
Think of one.
Really?
Yeah.
You haven't had one where you're like, oh fuck, I don't want to live through that again.
Nope.
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 Nope. I had one a long time ago. I was 7 years old.
Hmm.
And I had like a stomach parasite. Yeah, and I was bedridden for 2 weeks. And I remember waking up Christmas Day and hearing my entire family downstairs, having the time of their life with all the family, opening up all the presents. And I was just in... At one point, my temperature was so high, they had to dunk me in an ice bath. Just to bring my temperature down.
Radio check.
Two.
I've only had a temperature like that. I think once. And... It was when I was really little. And I don't, all I remember is like, my mom did this, I don't actually remember this, but she told me that like she had to do that, put me in the bath. And then I just remember being in the back of the car laying down at the ER.
Oof.
That's all I remember.
I love ice baths though. That's a me story.
I don't think I've ever had one.
Oh, there's something so like...
Sound terrible.
Oh, it's fantastic.
I hate being cold.
I mean... I learned a lot about... Because I was thinking about it and I was like... Most of the women I've known in my life have all are just always like they're cold all the fucking time. And it's actually because
I am always cold.
It's because women have different.
Always cold.
It's because women have different circulation as opposed to men. That's why I was like, "Do you wear socks in bed?" And you said no, and I was like, "I'm shocked." Me, on the other hand, I'm sort of the opposite. I get really fucking hot in bed. So I end up being like, don't fucking touch me. I'm a literal furnace. To the point where if it gets too hot, I will almost wake up in a fit of rage and like pull the thermostat off the fucking wall. I dated a girl that like would never like the second she got home would not wear socks, like they're cages for your feet. My dogs are barking. I'm craving a cup of coffee. And my stomach's fucked up. When are you not? Get coffee then. Yeah, but what if my tum-tum gets the wombles again? Do you have a unit responding to those 911s? I feel like if a cop doesn't respond to that... Hour from now? You won't drink coffee? Oh, you want a cup of coffee though. I drink coffee, no complaining later about the stomach. You okay there?
I told you I was sleepy.
Did I take your breath away there? Oh, that okay, then you need to go off duty. Mm-hmm. In that case, you need to go off duty if you're just full-on narcoleptic. Just
passed out? Yeah, probably.
Also, apparently someone just got rubbed at gunpoint. It's in your buns.
Really?
Yeah. And nobody
responding?
Nope.
To that, or?
I think we should go grab statements. No offense if the cat wants to. Unless you want to just wait for this.
I need to take another nap.
You want me to wait or head down there?
You can go.
Gee, thanks. Hey, I tried. I'm not gonna lie, chat. I don't usually watch my clips, but I'm not gonna lie. I was looking at the one of me finding out I was getting read rep, and I'm gonna be honest, bro. I was laughing my ass off at that last night. I was like, is this funny or is it me laughing at it that makes it funny? Hey, Jake, what's going on, cutie? First time chatter. Give him the sniff. Yep. Did they pass the vibe check? Also, I'll have the cam on for a little bit. Whoa. Chat, my hair has been looking nice the past couple of days. Real fluffy. I don't know what I did to it. I did nothing new. I think I accidentally left my conditioner in. I don't know. Love this community? Me too. You not have 2-1? Fuck no. I have more respect for myself. Yeah, but you could, there's nothing wrong with using Head and Shoulders. It's just Head and Shoulders 2-in-1 is just, there's no point. I use like a deep kind of oil one for my scalp, and then I've got like a coconut one that's for my conditioner for my hair. Took me ages to find one because otherwise my scalp sets on fire. No, bees, I don't. Oh, I did it. I did it, chat. I picked the scalp. Scalp. Scab. Different time today. That's a different. What's this, chat? Oh, I mean, this is a classic. This is an absolute classic clip right here. This is a VP who knew his club. Let me tell you, knew the club like the back of me fucking hand. I'm gonna turn my radio on. TJ is gonna be like, Colin. Colin. See. Right there. When I was in my shorts as well. This is summertime. I'm gonna turn. I'm always curious about scrolling through some of these clips because some of them are just like, oh, here's some GTRP, or it's just tits. This is tits. There's nothing wrong with tits. I personally find them fantastic. How deep is too deep? What is this? Yeah, I'm not Japanese, nor do I speak Japanese.
He poured hot oil all over me, and I freak out.
Wait, he assaulted you first?
I mean, James Randall assaulted me. Hey, wait. Can I send him to prison? What the fuck? Stay like that.
Yeah, this dude, like,
got a,
oh my god,
capacity.
I was laughing my ass off with this last night. I thought it was the funniest shit.
A for Michael 1276.
I'm getting rep from picking weed. Like, I don't know why I thought that was so funny that no one was like, hey, should we, cops that are investigating, someone was probably like, cops aren't probably going to go out and look for weed that much. Cut to McNulty. Yeah, dude.
Burp.
About made so much sense. I am the drug unit. Minulty's armor's cracked. One's cracked. Ooh, chat, how's oil looking? Ooh. Chat, I kind of want to throw another $1,000 into oil, dude. No, I didn't do the 10K yet. I haven't even grabbed my paycheck in a hot minute. We could go do that now. Wanna go grab our paycheck, chat? No, there's so many fucking head pops. I don't know what the fuck happened there. If my love is living in the West End.
Mm-hmm.
Part of the wave, can't stop. I'm guessing 21K. Holy shit! Damn! How much did the tax man get? Ooh. Oh, 56K in the bank! Adapted nearest when they need you. The love that may as I top to be. The love that may as I top to be. Part of the wave can't stop. Maybe I should not take another paycheck out till, Hey, gorgeous.
Court case we're supposed to be at. What?
Hi, officer. How are you doing today? I'm doing lovely. Thank you for asking.
I don't even sound like that, dude.
Well, no, I'm just saying. You know, I'm a human being. You can approach me with a hi, how are you? Give a moment, officer, before I scream a question at you like you're a fucking inanimate object.
I pay taxes. I don't.
Yeah, so do I. Yes, so do I.
Well. Why are you trauma dumping on me? I don't need your.
I'm not trauma dumping on you. Yes, I'm asking. Sure. I show you the same respect that I show you.
You know, I'm not mad. Because your name is McNulty. It's one letter away from McNonuts. Nulty.
Did you say it's one? One.
Two letters.
Okay, sir.
Are you okay, Carmine?
No. A lot's happened. I need to go to the courthouse. Right now, please.
Okay,
please.
I'm sure there's a goober or a taxi ride you can call.
Your prosecutor needs me for a taxi.
Are they at the courthouse?
I'm not prosecuting you.
But your prosecutor, your teammates need me.
I'm not prosecuting anyone.
Well, then.
Also, they're not there.
Needs us. What's going on? What happened?
Everyone appears to be having forced narcolepsy at the moment, so.
Great.
Yeah.
That's good.
All right, come over
here. Okay.
Have fun, you two. Wear protection.
You too, Officer McNulty. I don't even sound like that, man. I don't even sound like that.
Please, go back. I hope we have a lovely day, all right?
Quit fucking with me.
At least cuddle afterwards, you two, okay?
Man. That guy's a piece of work.
I like making myself laugh. Very cute couple.
They seem to bicker a lot.
Well, no relationship comes without, you know, a bit of bickering. Gotta work through it, you know?
I guess so.
I feel like Carmine's the bottom.
None of my business.
For real. Something there. I want to say, speaking of.
10-9.
Oh, shit.
Do I need an officer at Mission Pity? 197.
Yeah, 133.
I got a cop car and I need the keys for it downstairs. Can somebody come help me?
If you chuck it out, unless anybody else doesn't have keys, you might just have to park it, if you know what I mean.
I've been waiting for you.
Hey, Duncan. So, which category do you fall under? One, you're ticklish. Two, you're not ticklish. Or three, you are ticklish, but if anyone tries to tickle you, you basically assault them.
3.
You're number 3.
Yeah.
You seem like the type where you're like, where you'll tickle them and you'll be like, nah, stop. And then they'll try to tickle you and you're like, don't fucking touch me ever.
Yep.
Yeah. Or right, it's
fair enough.
Or it's like, you know,
are
you,
those two idiots there?
Or like you're
well,
you're
we don't
like,
need to call them names.
You're like play fighting a little bit and you know they kind of give you like a little slap and then you throw them across the room. That's like relationship escalation.
Are you ready to transport Vivek and Lilith?
Oh yeah.
Grab your vests. Cap's orders.
Happy?
Am I happy? I mean, yeah, I'm pretty okay.
Yesterday.
That's good.
My tummy hurts.
I'm sorry.
All right, get these cop cars. Let's go. Get behind. Let's go and escort to City Hall.
Are you taking us?
Got 2076 Central Medical 47.
Can I want to officer stay back and get those two cop cars inside?
Yes, Cam.
Sure.
Thank you.
You want to do?
It's your 20 bear.
I'll do it.
No. You go, Duncan. You go, Duncan.
Okay.
Did we just really stay here?
The thing is, we can't even slim jim these, so we'll fuck them up. Oh, I just have keys.
The 2023 Central Medical.
That was a fun bonding exercise for us, too.
I mean, we moved some cars.
No, we stood around. We had a police presence at MRPD. We talked about, you know, Christmas and socks. That's creepy. That guy back there?
He was waiting at the light, wasn't he?
Felt like he was watching us.
Hmm.
Should be. I have an idea for that second date if you're up for it. Oh!
What's that?
Well, you said you're before the ocean over the lake, so I thought we'd go deep sea swimming.
Deep sea swimming?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we could do that.
We can find a way to charter a little boat or something, or we just, you know, drive up.
Okay.
Big boy, the coast of Palito, because there's nice reef there. And I know if you don't go too far, sharks aren't little. Sharks aren't that crazy. There's more dolphins than anything else.
Hmm. Alright, that sounds nice.
McNulty RP weed and dates.
So did everybody have a headache?
I think everyone's having multiple headaches.
Hmm.
I woke up and it's sort of been, you know, nonstop.
Okay.
usually if it keeps happening, you know, everyone has a bit of a forced nap. Yeah, the way that I see it, you know, go on the second date. If there's no real chemistry there, we'll lock it in.
So, I'm working with Maple on something, and
hello.
So Maple and I, we were.
Oh yeah, you can leave it down there. I'll come grab it.
37, yesterday.
Okay, thanks. Bye.
And have you responded to any of those? Like, are you familiar with them?
The 37s, yeah.
Yeah. So, you know, like, what we found is, like, people try to take a car.
Mm-hmm.
So far. So we responded to one. We ended up pulling over the vehicle that we believed was taken from the house.
Mm-hmm.
Maple let the traffic stop, and I kind of gave him a hard time about it afterwards because the driver of the vehicle said he didn't have his ID on him. There were signs of tampering on the car. He couldn't identify the owner. And basically, Maple let him off and just said the car. I get where he was coming from because we couldn't get backup, so he was trying not to escalate. But at the same time, I was like, I think you were a little too lenient. And that's coming from me, who's pretty damn lenient all the time.
You know, yeah, I tend to be pretty forgiving, but I would have been like, okay, right. Not able to ID the driver, step out. I'm going to have this thing towed and brought to its rightful owner.
No, I mean, we took the car. We didn't let him go with the car or anything. But
oh.
But I was like, given the fact that he didn't have his ID, if it was me, I probably would have arrested him just to be able to identify him. It would have been one thing if we could identify him at least, like, you know, during the traffic stop.
Officer! Officer!
Is that my little friend? Okay.
McNulty from EMS?
Go from McNulty? One sec.
The 911 that I've just got is on your 20. Did someone just get run over?
Boy, the looks of it, yes.
Hey, from M76.
Okay, back away, please. Back away. Back, 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 back,
back, back, back,
back,
let's move him out of the road and then ask these people to clear their cars.
Okay, little friend, I'm here, okay? Okay, it's okay, little fella. Oh. Okay, I have my little friend here. Looks like he's been hit by a car.
Yes, I'm not a gremlin getting hit by a car.
Okay, he's not. Oh yeah, he's been hit by a car. He's not a gremlin. He's just little and stinky and has a long beard.
Oh, that guy!
I mean, if anything, he's a little troglodyte, but, you know, he's a cute one. Hey, buddy, it's me, friend. Don't worry. I have another friend on the way who's my friend, so she's your friend. Yeah, she's going to make sure you're okay.
Oh, honey.
That guy admits to hitting him with the car because he's going to jail.
I don't think he can even drive.
No, Francis got hit by a car.
Oh, no, I thought you were saying Pico did it.
No. Also, Francis can't drive.
Oh, honey.
So, did I hear someone say that they definitely ran him over with the car?
Well, yeah, we thought he was a local.
That's well, okay. What excuse is that?
Hubcap did say he ran him over with prejudice.
With prejudice.
155.
Oh, well, he's going to jail then.
42.
Yeah, what about this guy? He just ran Pico over.
Hey, Mr. Hubcap, is it?
Yeah.
You have to face away from me there, brother.
Why?
Well, you just said you ran this man over with prejudice, so.
No, no, no. I thought he was a local, so I ran him over.
So you, okay, that does not matter.
What do you mean?
You thought he was a person, and you tried to run them over, and you did.
Yeah, with prejudice, though.
Yeah, it was a local.
You ran someone over with your car. I'm sorry, I don't know what to say to you.
On purpose.
On purpose, so face away from me.
When I saw them, I'm like, I'm going to just keep
Okay, well
driving.
Then face away from me, please.
What?
You ran someone over with your car. You've admitted to me, yeah, I ran them over. I tried to.
Yeah. I came back because when we came
back. Yeah, so, okay, I'm going to ask you to turn away. I'm going to put you in a cuffs, and we're going
to
have a conversation. Okay. Easy as that.
Hopcap, he needs a ride to the hospital. We gotta take him.
Yeah. All right. Well, hop in my tow truck. We can go over there. I'm gonna.
No,
go
I can make. No,
hospital.
I can make sure he gets medical. So I'm gonna ask you one more time before I just force you into cuffs.
I feel really bad. So I
okay, don't worry.
Apologize.
I need 52s down here on this Vespucci and peaceful for a man who's currently being carried away in a tow truck. All right, face away from me, please.
No.
Sir,
now you're adding resisting arrest.
Don't resist.
This doesn't need to be more than oh for.
Echo 101 in room.
I don't get this. Oh yeah, I hit someone with my car.
Get in.
Well, you take care, strangers.
Oh yeah, we're adding resisting arrest.
No, I didn't resist arrest.
Not you, Hubcap.
Hubcap, please.
And if you drive, I'm giving you evading.
I gotta go to the hospital now.
You're getting evading if you accelerate out of here. This can be so simple if you step out of the car and work with me instead of against. I don't understand what's so hard about this. I really don't.
I'm out in the parking garage. I'm going to be storing a majority of the vehicles that we have on scene on the second floor.
Ran me over.
Okay, copy. I was just making sure. Do you need help?
Fist him.
I should be fine.
No, I'm not going to fist him.
Okay, go for cuffs.
Sir, in the white chair, I'm going to ask you to step away a little bit.
Units of the courthouse as well. Vehicles from outside are going
to
be on the second floor of the parking garage.
I'm
going
to ask you to step away if you want to go stand with your friend over there.
Okay, wait, which way?
Anybody that might
Holy shit, is everyone here 100 years old?
Well, you said go this way!
Yeah, there's a lot of old people around.
I didn't expect him to walk this way.
Nothing wrong with that. I love old people. I think they're adorable.
Mm-hmm.
Did your name was Hubcap?
I gotta go get... Yeah. Here you go! Here you go, come in!
I don't understand what was so crazy about this. Am I in the wrong? Okay, Mr. Jones, you have the right to remain silent and say cannot be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to attorney present available if you can't afford one, will be appointed to you free of charge by the state. Hold on. Before I finish that, do you think I'm reading that too fast?
I don't think so.
No. Oh, so maybe it's just people then.
I understand what you're saying.
Some people have trouble understanding him when he reads them the rights.
Maybe the Irish accent or something. They're not used to other accents.
You have the right to remain. Then this makes it sound like I'm... Makes it sound like I'm reading off a fucking cue card.
Right. No, I think you're fine.
Thank you. Do you understand these rights other than to you, Sir Mehmet, or Demonday?
I understand them, yeah.
Okay, so... Yeah. Is vehicular manslaughter a charge? Although you said you did it with prejudice.
Well, yeah.
Okay, yeah. You two, I'm going to ask you to step away. This isn't a... Gallery or a zoo.
It's okay, I'm a doctor.
That has nothing to do with it. Well, I know you are. I've met you before, but I ask you to step away. Thank you.
It's okay. I only use my words.
Cool. What? Now step away.
Unless it's a fisting.
I'm not fisting right now, Randall.
Okay.
Okay, so what you're telling me is you saw someone out in the middle of the road... And you were like, I'm going to accelerate my tow truck and run them over.
Well, it wasn't accelerate. It was just, I'm just going to keep driving because I thought it was a local asshole standing in the middle of the road like an idiot.
Was he standing in the crosswalk?
Yeah, but he was just standing there in the middle of the road.
Maybe he
dropped
something.
Pedestrians don't have rights in a crosswalk.
It's kind of the
just
opposite.
Standing there.
Sir.
Was I at a green light? Actually, I had no. I don't
Do
even.
Do you have any priors?
No,
one of negligent driving.
Yeah, I'm a good citizen of the city. I've never done anything wrong while living here, except for that you just mentioned, and that's it. And this is just an unfortunate incident of
spontaneous utterance top, and then I read him his rights, and he said yes, that's what I said. So
what I thought was a local with prejudice, you know, which means malice.
Yeah. That...
Correct. Like I thought about it and went, yeah, I know. Yes, I want to do this. And I just kept driving, and someone in the car went, what was that? And I went, I don't know, because it's funny to say that when things like that happen. And then we drove somewhere else, and then we drove back by this area, and so people are like, help us. And we stopped. We're like, what's going on? And then we realized there was a short, bearded man laying there, and I thought, well, I wonder if that's... who I ran over, but I thought it was, you know, one of these locals that likes to stand on the road or the highway. They just stand there like an idiot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Probably, you know, still shouldn't run over that.
Well, I did it with prejudice.
I'm glad you're just admitting. I really respect that.
Well, I mean, I'm not.
We're gonna go see if Francis wants to push charges.
All right.
Wait, can I have the key to the car?
I'll be back at some point. They need the exercise. Don't worry about it.
What did we run over?
We'd run everyone over. Huh? At most, you're probably looking at assault with a deadly.
Yeah, I mean, I accept that. It's fine.
Just going to see if what Francis wants
it,
to do.
So, yeah, that's all. Felt really bad when we came back, and I mean, it was just a short man with a glorious beard. I mean, that's not what I thought was going on there at all.
Okay, I'll stay with the 95. Do you want to go grab Francis wants to push charges? Archer.
All right.
Oh no, are we having a headache?
I'm not.
Am I out of the car? Are you out of the car?
Yeah.
No.
I'm still in the car.
Because I said I'll stay with the 95. Do you want to go chat with Francis?
Oh, I thought.
Or do you? Do you?
I'll go talk to him.
Sure.
Period. I see him.
Lights are on. Help! I don't know why. lights are on. It's an emergency. Deep breath, bud. Being ironic? That's not ironic. You're being a silly goose. What time did we say? An hour? 34 minutes ago. Okay. We gotta go make a suit. Never die alone. Made it up. And I'm gone. Red suit. Oh, I don't know what McNulty's going to look like in a red suit. That's going to be hard with his hair color.
Think he wants to push he wants to press charges?
You think?
I told him we were going to after I asked him, and he said he kind of said yes. And then he asked me who made the universe.
What? So you, he maybe wants to push charges? Where'd he go? Hold on. Friend? Friend? Hey, come here a sec. My room alone. He didn't comply, and he has been. He did pretty much admit it. What are you feeling?
He did admit it. There's no pretty much about it. He admitted to running. I mean, I guess he didn't intend to run that man specifically over, but he
did
intend to run a person over.
So I'm thinking assault with deadly.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right.
Bones, you on frequency?
Hey, go ahead and say it.
I think yourself, Maple, and I should stand out in the hallway while the three witnesses are out there.
Okay, yeah.
Just to make sure nothing happens.
In my room alone. On 3323 MRPD. Alright, you wanna get a move document? I'll throw the report up and get the charges in.
Yeah.
Okay. I haven't searched them, by the way.
Okay, I'll search him.
Wow. Look at... No.
$50k enough money for a car yet? Yeah, I'm not getting a car though. Saving up for a house. Oh, I'm saving up for the dream house. I'm not, I feel like a lot of people are like, we gotta buy a house and get things moving. But I'm saving up. Yeah, decorating. Alright, there's no way I'm fucking decorating.
And, do you want the big cell, or do you want a little cell?
Oh, I don't know. What's, what are the cell? Where are the cell? Oh, there's like hallways with cells.
Like, there's like, do you want to see them?
Yeah. Them. What's that all about? Yeah. Oh, you got like isolation cells almost. Oh my God.
I know. It's a lot different than it used to be. Huh?
Yeah, you can't yell at everybody.
You
can still yell through the little slot in there. Okay, how about this big one right here? It might make it easier for you.
So yeah, sometimes I go into those cells just to be alone.
Yeah, I could understand that.
Like a, what do they call them?
Okay, if you wouldn't, I'll uncuff you.
Sensory deprivation chambers.
Oh, yeah.
Just laying there with my headphones and just...
A little meditation.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean...
Okay, so I did all the things. I fingerprinted him, got his DNA, took a picture. So I'll process all that.
Yeah, my statement's already in. Just get what's his face is in. Little fella Bruce. Francis.
I mean, yeah, I'll put in there that
he wanted
to... kind of wants to press charges and that he wants to know who created the universe.
Yeah. That's good. I'll get talking to him, okay? All right, Mr. Jones.
Yeah.
Pretty straightforward stuff. Okay. Assault with the Deadly. It's going to come with 21 months and a $960 fine. How do you plead these charges?
Guilty. That's fine.
Okay, yeah, I will not be sending you up to Bolingbroke today.
Oh, okay.
You are going to serve some of your time out here for the guilty plea. I'm going to give you about 10 months. You and I can just sit here for the 10, and I'll be buffing you and cutting you loose.
Sounds good.
There's your bill.
All righty.
No, it doesn't really fit. So, do you find yourself accelerating and running people over pretty often?
When I see them standing in the middle of the road. That's it.
Hope Gab, I think I know what happened. You were like, oh, isn't there a thing where if a deer runs out in front of your car, you're supposed to accelerate and not hit the brakes?
Well, I did accelerate. I just kept the same speed.
You were like, well, the insurance will cover it.
Well, look. Okay, I've lived in this city a long time, and locals really, look, they deserve it, man, okay? Let's just be real here, okay? They stand in the middle of the road for hours, just standing there, causing accidents, you know, making people swerve out of the way. Yeah, and the thing with the deer, you're supposed to stay straight on the road, right? So that, because if you swerve, you could end up in the ditch and kill yourself or... That's the thing about the deer. You're supposed to just, you know, and if, especially if it's a winter time, you slam on the brakes, you end up fucking sliding all over the place.
Oh, yeah.
You just hit the deer. It sucks, but you just sort of take your foot off the gas and don't try to swerve.
Just let Jesus take the wheel.
Pretty much. I mean, well, yeah, you just kind of keep it going straight. But then, so with locals, you know, I mean, I care about people. I'm very sensitive. But when it's a local is standing in the middle of the road for hours on end, just stand in the middle of the street.
You know? I'd love if you were like, you know what, I'm taking him to trial. They'd be like, Your Honor, he was in the middle of the road. He deserved it.
I think some people in the city would be sympathetic to the way I'm thinking about
it. Yes, but I would agree to some degree, but you hit a person, so...
Yep, I was gonna run, and I thought, you know what? I did that shit, and yeah. I had to just fucking do the time, and yeah, I did that. I felt real bad about it, because I'd never just run somebody over, you know, unless they were a local, stay in the middle of the street for hours.
Well, yeah, in my own admittance, while I've been on pursuits, I've had a local walk out in front of me, but I'll pull over just in case and go, hello?
Yeah, I probably should have. But I mean, I was so sure.
I feel like there's times out there where, you know, other people have been like, that was a local I shot. And then they'll just hear,
yeah.
And you'll be like, oh.
I think I'm a little traumatized now. I think that run is over. That spree of running over locals I've had for years. Mm. It's over now.
I gotta use the little cops room.
Alrighty.
I feel like cops piss in the cells when they need to. I feel like that's a cop thing.
How's it going?
Oh, it's all right. Yeah, I've played a few concerts. You know, Liquid Library did a few, and I think I played one Tequila Lala already. So. Oh. Yeah, I've played two or three, man, three or four shows since the city, you know, has been rebuilt, and yeah, it's going good, just rocking and rolling. Yeah,
that's great.
How's the new police force?
You know, we're trying.
Yeah,
you know,
that's all you can do.
Trying to respond as much as we can. Yeah. A lot of stabbings.
Yeah, I've been stabbed. Yeah. Someone stabbed me the other day, right in the gut.
Oh, God. You okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Someone shot me the other day, too.
I'm sorry, what?
Someone shot me with a gun.
Who?
I don't know. Don't know who they were. They were wearing
when?
A mask. Yesterday.
Where?
South side.
Jesus.
Yeah, I went to the hospital twice.
Did you file a report? Did
no?
Did you tell any police?
No.
Do you want to file a report?
No, I don't really have enough details to even matter.
I mean, getting shot is a pretty big deal. Getting stabbed isn't a big deal, but
I've lived in this city for. Like a lot of years, and I've been shot, stabbed, everything you can imagine, tortured, thrown off buildings. You know, I've been really lucky to still be alive, but I don't know. So there's just some peons with guns just thought they were being tough and decided to shoot an old man.
How many were there?
Well, it's two separate incidents. It was about 2 days ago, so it wasn't yesterday, I wasn't awake. But, both times, single people. Angry. Real angry. Okay, the first one I met, I was trying to buy a guitar off of them. Guitars are really hard to come by in the city.
Okay.
And, they pinged me to the south side, so I go to the south side. It was up some stairs in like a covered stairway in a two-story complex of apartments or something, and it was this covered stairway. You couldn't really see. That's probably why they lured me there. I don't know. They didn't take anything off of me that I could tell, but they fucking shot me, and I, you know.
Is this somebody you called off of Yellow Pages, or?
Yeah, someone was offering used items for sale. Now.
Used items?
Yeah, items. Used items for sale. And I called them, I said, hey, could I get, do you have any guitars for sale? Like, yep, we got two different guitars. And I'm like, well, I'm pretty desperate to get a guitar because.
You don't remember the name?
No. It was a couple of days ago. I just saw used items. I thought, what the hell? I'll call and just ask. They're like, yeah, we got two guitars. I'm like, holy shit. So they pinged me.
Did you by chance text this person? Or?
No, it was just a call. I called them, and then they pinged me to the location. I went, and I'm like, hey, I'm here for the guitar. And he pulled out a gun. He's like, give me all your shit. I'm like, what the hell? And I went to pull out my knife to defend myself, and they just blap, blap.
Would, you know. You said this happened day before yesterday?
Why'd you only call me when you're high?
Later on in the day, I was meeting someone. They said they were giving away free massages, back massages,
how about Ryan? I'm excited what you bring us this year and the years to come. You won't have a commute in your stream. You haven't been to a lot the last 18 months. Much love, Custy. Thank you so much, man.
It was the south side. Different spot this time. And the fucking same situation. They tried to rob me and they shot me.
Yeah.
Okay. McNulty, can I talk to you?
Of course.
Hubcap said he got shot. Two different incidents. Day before yesterday, said that he called people off of Yellow Pages. He was trying to buy something, a guitar, and they basically took him into like a parking covered parking garage. And I think they were gonna try to rob him, and they shot him. He said they didn't take anything, but I'm wondering if. Do you think it would be too forward to ask if we could subpoena his phone records from day before yesterday to see if we can figure out who he called?
Yeah, I'd say go ahead. I'd say he's willing to, it sounds like he's cooperative, so. We've already had a shooting where some people are being let out. It's got to do with the sanitation unions. Where there are these two sanitation unions and the other one is leading them out and shooting them. Was he doing sanitation?
I know he was just. I think somebody had posted. You can ask him, but somebody had posted in Yellow Pages, you know, selling used items or something like that. And he asked if they had a guitar, and they said, "Oh yeah, I have two." And I guess he pinged him, but he doesn't remember the name.
You can ask. I'd say ask. It's a fair ask.
Well, do you want to ask about the sanitation?
Yeah, thing? Well, when you were shot and robbed, were you running sanitation?
No.
Were you just calling someone about something?
Yeah.
Can you recall the last four digits of the phone number? I know that's a tall ask.
No, I can't.
Can you give me a description of the individual?
Black mask, like a, balaclava mask, black. Ridged, wool, I think. Looked fairly new. Suit, like a cheap, skinny, like skinny fit suit.
Red tie?
No, all black.
What
black
kind of accent?
American. Just like a neutralish.
Oh,
you know,
okay.
Very
right.
Flat. Yeah.
Ask away, Archer.
And then, yeah.
This is, you know, it's a little bit of a big ask, but would you be willing to consent to us subpoenaing your phone records from the day before yesterday so we can try to figure out who you called? We would just be looking for that phone call. We don't even need to subpoena the text messages or anything, just the phone records, the phone call records. If you could give us even an approximate time of day, we can narrow it down even further.
Nah.
Okay, that's fine.
That's fine. That's your prerogative, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, you've got about 2 months left, okay?
Yeah.
No worries.
Well, it's been a good couple of...
Yeah, I'm sure you've learned your lesson.
If you do change your mind, I'm generally in Yellow Pages, so feel free to give me a call, okay?
All right. Now I'll let you know if I get shot again.
Yeah, please do.
Yeah, I was genuinely surprised. I didn't see anyone with a gun.
You can.
At all.
But it happened the other day, so chances are I didn't save the number. You know?
You know, we want to get these guns up off the street.
Yeah.
Do whatever it takes.
You know, I've acquired just a knife for self-defense and for cutting things like, you know, wood and whatever else, the whittling. But, there's not much I can do if someone's got a friggin' gun. You know?
Yeah. No. Unfortunately, there isn't.
Think of all the weed that's hidden out there, Jed.
Yeah. Yeah, I was worried.
And there's going to be some right there. Yeah, right there in the water. I haven't actually checked.
So all the ad said was what? Selling used items?
Items. Yep. Selling used items.
That's all it said?
Yep. And I thought, well, maybe they've got, you know, like a pawn shop would have used guitars. So I just thought that's a good connection to a guitar, maybe. So they said they did have, but obviously there was just a scam.
No recollection of the name.
No. I'm really bad with names anyway.
That's okay.
Yeah.
There's no chance you saved me your phone?
No.
Alright. It's fine. Okay.
Ooh. I come home. Surprises, let me know she cares. Ooh, that's gonna be a case. Gay one. Oh, yeah, guys, I was robbed. I was shot. You know. Oh, you want me to help you? Oh, no.
I don't know. People don't like to snitch. It is what it is.
Okay. Maybe time's up. Did he just... Oh my god.
He had weapons on him, so you're gonna want to soft cuff him.
Gotcha. Alright, Mr. Jones. Darling, Dr. Jones, get up now. You remember that banger?
Oh, yeah.
Baby, I've been missing you. I need you by my side. Can you face away from me?
Yep. Banger.
All right, grab your items for me here.
At the desk here, yeah.
And double check that. Okay, just gonna hold your wrist while your items are put back on you, okay?
Alright. There we go, I got them.
We gotta bring that up to Slacks.
What, that they can't grab?
Yeah.
Their stuff when they're soft cupped?
Yeah, it just makes it real like awkward, you know? Oh, go ahead.
Yeah. It's that way.
This way.
Gotta go backwards to go forwards.
Yeah, I guess.
All Okay, Mr. Jones, appreciate the complaints today. Maybe think twice before driving someone over in the middle of the street, okay?
Oh, yeah, believe me, I will.
Yeah, all right, appreciate the complaints. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, take care, sir.
See ya.
I don't know. I guess I'll just watch Yellow Pages, and if I see anybody selling used items, maybe...
Yeah, I'm looking out for a number as well. Same one that's in that bolo. The 420-947-6475.
If we subpoena somebody, right? But they have an extra SIM card or, like, I don't know. Let's say they have a crime SIM card. What do we even do, you know?
I don't know. It's going to become messy because we have to articulate that that SIM card was used. Like, if we have the number, we can link it to that SIM card and obviously subpoena that SIM card. But then it's about how can I articulate potentially the second SIM card was used. But it's just a little bit... It's going to be a little messy, we think. But growing pains.
Yeah.
I might clock off.
Okay.
Sorry to leave.
Not feeling well?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, I hope you feel better.
Thank you. Whenever you're free, maybe tomorrow or the day after, we can go on that swim.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah, just hit me up, okay?
Okay.
I don't know if I want to keep streaming just because my stomach is a little iffy. And I haven't even sipped coffee yet. It's not a hangover. Something is like straight up not good in my tum-tum. Sober up. rot gut. What the f- Number up. No, I definitely ate. I really don't know what hit me that hard. Let's go to a clothing store and we'll figure this out. I'm going to change this fucking back. Get this backpack off just as a little quick casual look. I thought the... Close enough. Burr. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what I want to do. Ah, fuck it. We'll stick it through. I probably just would have offlined anyway, so... She's a fucking nightmare. I need a girl that I can change. Now to say the most outlandish shit I can think of. Nothing warm with you? Perio. Oh god, no. I can't put on the red dress. The barber's kind of fucking me. I don't think I can make McNulty look like McNulty. Can't do the hair. I think I can do the beard, but I don't know if I can shape his face. Faster we're falling, we're rocking and stalling. Really curious what this building is. Or what it's going to be. While the guys can't wear dresses? I mean, it's just a ped thing. That's it. There's nothing more to it than it's just a ped thing. That's it. I got my red. Oh my god. I could have blasted. I could have blasted fucking Summertime Sadness. I got my red dress on tonight. That's annoying. Time sadness. Yeah, you're the best. They're restarting the server. That's gonna be skiing. Oh my god! Oh, it's okay, Kit Kat, you're fine. Then there's me anymore. Kiss me hard before you go. Summertime sadness. This playlist is called... Ooh, good starting song. I'm gonna use the washroom chat.
Damn, I've been Canadianized.
A natural sight. You know what I wanted to listen to? One hit wonder. It's like a movie scene. Then to the end of the night. Chow, I'm actually just, I don't think I have the stomach to focus on chatting and engagement with my stomach kind of like this. Sugar is live. Okay, good. Go over there, guys. I don't have the energy to keep up engagement and RP. I just don't. Otherwise, I'm just sitting here, like, staring. Yeah. Right. I will give you guys an update tomorrow if I'm okay enough to do, like, a